Reminding you to boost Buffalo. It's good for you. This is YouTube channel staffannouncer.com Buffalo.
This is First Team News with John Corbett, Chuck Lampkin, Chuck Healy, and Kevin O'Connell.
Good evening. Fresh help loomed today for snow-stricken western New York, an estimated $3 million being earmarked to hire unemployed workers to clear snow. The Army sent troops and equipment into the snow battle, and a federal emergency program began to take effect, as Ray Finch reports.
In a residential section of the Erie County town of Elma, Harry Wirtz is opening up roads that have been blocked for 5 days. Harry's powerful high lift is not part of the town highway department. It belongs to his employer, the Oak Grove Construction Company. Oak Grove, one of nearly 40 private firms which have contracted with the Army Corps of Engineers to help in the massive federal state snow removal effort. Here on Griffin Lane off Girdle Road, Harry Wirtz's efforts freed 17 persons stranded in a single home where food had been brought in only by snowmobile. The nerve center for the giant snow blitz is located in the Buffalo District Office of the Corps of Engineers, where nearly 75 specialists have been working round the clock since Monday. They've fielded about 100 requests from various town highway departments and municipal governments. Those requests first funneled through the State Department of Transportation, which sets priorities for the program. The engineers then assign the jobs to the private contractors and their nearly 100 pieces of equipment hired by the hour. A rough estimate of the overall cost, $1 million. The program is just now moving into high gear.
Well, I think it's certainly progressing. It was a little slow getting the contractors out there and everything, but now that they're out there, they're moving, probably not as fast as everybody would like and as fast as we would like, because the drifts out there are tremendous. They really are, and sometimes the capability is a little limited. But the big thing is getting them out there and working on it.
The record storm spared no one, but the drifts in some rural townships are monumental. It took the heaviest equipment to open up Blossom Road in the town of Elma, where entire houses are hidden behind mountains of snow. The men and machines who have hired on to dig out western New York are going to earn their money. Ray Finch, First Team News.
The federal official coordinating the snow relief effort in western New York said this afternoon that no decision has been made on whether the region will be declared a major disaster area. Thomas Casey said that such a designation would not make any difference now in the snow cleanup effort.
If I had a major disaster declaration right now, I would have no more authority nor more tools to do the job that I have to do right now. If I had the major disaster declaration, I wouldn't be doing anything more than I'm doing right now. Particularly the additional feature of a major disaster declaration would be the retroactive reimbursement to communities for snow removal costs that they've incurred.
Casey said President Carter is well briefed on the situation here, that the ultimate decision to designate Western New York a major disaster area will be made in the White House when all of the necessary information is gathered and sent to the President. Casey said the Army Corps of Engineers is looking ahead to the next problem, the potential of major flooding as the snow melts over the next few months. The federal government is making $3 million available to 7 Western New York counties to hire the unemployed for snow clearance. And Casey noted communities can begin that hiring immediately because the money is committed. Don Ketchum of the State Department of Transportation issued a familiar plea that people keep cars off the highways so that snow removal is not delayed by traffic and abandoned cars. Ketchum estimates the area cleanup will take up to 2 weeks if we don't get another serious storm. Ron Arnold, First Team News.
And local officials, headed by Buffalo Mayor Stanley Mikoski and Erie County Executive Edward Regan, continued to push for President Carter to declare much of western New York a major disaster area. Many officials are irked that the administration has taken no such action, particularly since southern Florida received such a designation only 2 days after a cold snap ruined citrus crops just a few weeks ago. The series of storms that have hit western New York are now being blamed for the deaths of at least 21 persons. 9 died in Buffalo and 5 in the city's suburbs within Erie County. Local economic observers estimated that about 250,000 Buffalo area workers were off the job and that they were losing from $12 to $15 million daily in wages.
The Buffalo Area Chamber of Commerce has estimated losses to business, industry, and workers at about $60 million. A massive military airlift operation to bring badly needed military equipment and manpower to Erie County got underway early this morning. Alan Laughlin reports from Niagara Falls Air Force Base.
The first plane arrived in the pre-dawn hours at Niagara Falls Air Force Base. The plane carried a load of snow-removing equipment from New York City. Buffalo's Mayor Stanley Mikulski waited at the air base most of the night to watch the equipment being unloaded. In the late morning, a second flight, an Air Force C-5A, the biggest plane the Air Force has, flew in with the next load of equipment, two rotary snowplows loaned to Erie County by the Public Works Department of Nassau County on Long Island. The equipment was unloaded from the giant Air Force jet and taken immediately to the Buffalo area to begin several days, perhaps a week or maybe more, of badly needed snow removal. 20 miles away at Buffalo Airport, another airlift by the National Guard was still going on. Guardsmen had been working in the area for 3 days and had to call for more men and equipment, especially high loaders, to help haul snow away. Then came regular Army troops, the first of more than 30 plane loads of engineers and equipment from Fort Bragg, North Carolina. The airlift was scheduled to last most of the night. In all, more than 600 National Guardsmen, 300 regular Army troops, and dozens of pieces of snow fighting gear are being brought in to tackle the more than 13 feet of snow that have fallen in the Buffalo area since the week before Thanksgiving. Alan Laughlin, First Team News, Niagara Falls Air Force Base.
All right, here's the situation as of now. A state of emergency still exists in five places: Lancaster, Newstead, Sardinia, Wales, and Buffalo. That means absolutely no driving except essential services there. The Erie County Sheriff's Department says it is making headway in clearing roads throughout the area, but asks people to please not drive if at all possible. Cars only block progress in clearing the roads.
Put a little change in your life.
Put a little kicks in your morning.
Start your day the nutritious way. Come on and get your kicks. Put a little change in your life. Put a little corn in your morning. Try the crisp kicks way. I'll start your day. Start it out with good old kicks. Kicks. Get your kicks.
Sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't. Almond Joy's got nuts, mounds don't. Almond Joy's got real milk chocolate, coconut and munchy nuts too. Mounds got deep dark chocolate and chewy coconut. Sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't. Peter Paul, Almond Joy's got nuts, Peter Paul, mounds don't.
Because
sometimes you feel like a nut, sometimes you don't.
Despite that ban against non-essential traffic, many motorists took to Buffalo streets anyway today. Jim Peppard filed this report.
Buffalo streets were supposed to be used for emergency vehicles or for private citizens whose work is considered essential to health and safety. But a spot check in the Elmwood and Bidwell area saw car after car testing the roads, most of them appearing to be in no emergency situation. One big problem with the driving ban is enforcement. Buffalo police are too busy to stop and check every motorist, and the community service officers have no power to make arrests. As it is, police did make at least 62 arrests, those persons now facing fines or jail terms if convicted. Tonight, the ban on non-emergency traffic in Buffalo is continued, but Mayor Mikulski has extended his exemptions from the driving ban to include bankers and employees of financial institutions. State equipment attacked the Kensington Expressway today, but even the big rotary and plow ran into problems. A wayward muffler got caught in the works, delaying the cleanup operations until it could be removed from the blades. Private contractors moved in the Skajakwita Expressway near Delaware Park. They used graders and high lifts to unclog the driving lanes and reopen the ramps. The snow is being hauled to Delaware Park and then dumped there. The biggest problem for them, of course, is getting the abandoned cars out of the way so the rigs can get to the snow. Many cars abandoned on the thruway were towed into the parking lot of the Hutchinson Hose Company in Amherst. The fire hall served as a refugee center during the height of the storm. Now it's a claim center. Many of the cars brought here show signs of damage from accidents that stalled thruway traffic days ago or from snowplows that abruptly uncovered the cars during removal operations. Insurance companies and collision shops are gearing up to deal with this phase of the Buffalo snow blitz. Jim Peppard, First Team News.
On the list of storm-disabled vehicles in Buffalo is a city fire truck, Ron Arnold reports.
Engine 9 got stuck in the deep snow Friday night at Virginia and Whitney Place while helping fight a three-alarm fire that destroyed several homes, damaged three others. Water from the fire hoses turned to solid ice, locking the $60,000 engine to the street. Crews from the Niagara Mohawk Power Company brought in special equipment today to try and free Engine 9, which was also a target for vandals.
Yes, it was. It was stripped. The radio was stripped out of there, and as you can see, the bell was taken off of there. And before the companies could get back here Saturday morning to take the rest of it, yes.
Yeah, some other equipment been vandalized.
Yes, we had Squad 8 over on Hamburg in Miami, which was also vandalized. The radio was taken off, and the first aid equipment was just, and vandalized is the word because they just threw it all over the street.
What kind of punishment would you like to see these people get who do this?
I would like to see the most severe punishment and as soon as possible. I understand they arrested some people last night, and I think they should be brought to trial immediately so that if there are any potential looters, they would realize that this is a serious matter and they're going to be dealt with in the harshest manner.
Commissioner Kubiak, with the road conditions so bad down here, what would you do if we had another fire in this neighborhood?
There's nothing we could do. We can't get close enough to a fire in this area. It's very critical. We'd have to drag hose lines for blocks, and then we're not sure that all the hydrants are thawed out. So I'm going to get the water department down here today and see what they can do to see if the hydrants are operative.
Are you hopeful that the federal government will declare this a major disaster area so that perhaps we could get some money to replace equipment like this?
Yes, we are hoping they do declare a major disaster area. If the officials would come down to an area like this and see what actually happened with ice 4 or 5 feet thick in some places, I believe it would convince them that we would qualify as a disaster area.
The streets in the Virginia Whitney Place area are absolutely impassable. Cars are locked in by snow and ice for blocks around. Officials are just hoping that there won't be another fire here before the area finally comes up on the priority list for snow removal. Ron Arnold, First Team News.
Attempts are being made to return the postal service in western New York to normal. Postmaster William Miller has called up all his personnel and says it will still take 3 to 4 days to get completely back to normal. That is, if we don't get any more snow. More on the postal situation from L.B. Lyon.
Many of the suburban post offices made attempts today to make home deliveries again. The Amherst area, for example, was cleaned up enough that home deliveries were resumed. The hard-hit areas, such as Marilla, Lancaster, and Alden, and some of the southern county sections were not as lucky, as delivery men could not get through. The lines grew in the post offices as people jammed into mail items and buy stamps. There's a backlog of mail that will take some time to sort out before being shipped out for delivery. Financial support checks that usually are delivered on the 1st have been delayed because of the snow, but the post office is working with a full force and hopes to get caught up this week. L.B. Lyon, First Team News.
Emergency medical supplies were airlifted by the National Guard today from Buffalo to Hornell. The choppers left their Niagara Falls base and flew to Sherrill Warehouse on Kenmore Avenue to carry about 285 pounds of intravenous sets destined for St. James Mercy Hospital. The hospital ran out of anticoagulant solutions when ground transportation of supplies was blocked by the snow. The helicopters made the one-mile trip in 1 hour. Sheila Allen, First Team News.
Why would a family leave the big city life to live in the wilderness? You'll see why in an exciting motion picture, The Adventures of the Wilderness Family. It's a true story as wide as the human heart. Rated G.
Held over limited engagement at selected theaters in Buffalo and surrounding areas. Now showing 4 days only, Warren. Starts Friday, 3 days only, Angola, Gowanda, Westfield, Silver Creek, Port Allegheny. Starts Sunday, 3 days only, Wellsville and Springville. The Adventures of the Wilderness Family. Look for this ad in your newspaper.
You've been racing long and hard. Now it's daybreak, and you get time for breakfast. Just 3 minutes flat. What'll it be? Carnation Instant Breakfast. Mixed with milk, all the nourishment of this bacon and egg meal. Ready right now. In a hurry? Don't worry. With Carnation Instant Breakfast, you can always have a good breakfast.
Love that Super Duper.
Hi. Thank goodness Super Duper stores are open and are doing everything possible to keep supplies rolling into the stores. Because of the weather conditions this week, be sure to check for in-store specials that could save you money at Super Duper's throughout this area.
Love that Super Duper.
Believe it or not, some communities in Erie County kept their snow plows a step ahead of the storm, like Lackawanna, Tonawanda, and Amherst. But a little village just north of Buffalo continues to amaze some.
Kenmore has always had a good reputation for moving snow. They do it quickly, efficiently, and constantly. Kenmore was in good shape this week while Buffalo reeled in the blizzard. Today, Kenmore crews spent their time tidying up streets and rearranging the piles in Mang Playground, just in case they need more room. Sure, you say, Kenmore is good, but they restrict parking. It would be a different story if they had to plow Buffalo. Sunday, Kenmore shattered that idea. They volunteered to clear a big chunk of snowbound North Buffalo with just five plows and three tractors.
Geez, it kind of scared me to see the situation as it was with all the abandoned cars that were in the middle of the intersections. And the first thing we had to do was remove the cars, and we had to tow them over to the curb line so we could get a plow down the street to do anything. We had so many cars parked along the streets that it was hard for the plows to go down and trying to avoid any damage to the cars that were parked there.
Here's an example of the difference the Kenmore plowing in North Buffalo made. This is Beard Avenue in Buffalo. Not bad, huh? Well, this was plowed by Kenmore 3 days ago. Now take a look at Beard on the other side of Hurdle Avenue, where the Kenmore plows didn't go. That's the difference. It will be a long time before anyone forgets this storm, but it will be even longer before North Buffalo residents forget what Kenmore did for them when they needed it most.
They come through with their plows. I saw about six of them go up and down about three or four times. They know how to plow, and they don't mess around.
Did they do a better job than Buffalo?
A lot better.
Residents of Ashland Avenue in Buffalo conducted a snow blitz of their own today. The whole neighborhood between Bird and Potomac was out with coal shovels, pickaxes, and ice choppers, breaking off hard-packed snow in chunks, clearing a street that has not been plowed for some time. They cleared a section, moved a parked car, then got back to clearing the street. And those who weren't shoveling manned a coffee and sandwich brigade, a stand in the middle of the street. The neighborhood effort paid off. The army of shovelers cleared Ashland Avenue right down to the pavement, curb to curb.
National Fuel Gas was out checking thermostats in business places today. They called compliance to the 55-degree setting pathetic. National Fuel Gas sent out about 50 people, supervisors, office people, even one of their tax accountants, to check business places and enforce the 55-degree rule. They checked a total of 42 places, found 11 stores in compliance, 16 not too high, but still above 55, 15 where the temperature was over 65. After a double check, National Fuel Gas has the authority to shut the gas off if the thermostats in stores are not set at 55. National Fuel Gas will continue its daily checks. County Executive Regan says all county offices in the downtown area will be open tomorrow. County employees are urged to take NFTA buses to work. Those who cannot are to form carpools and have county ID cards to show to police.
Ashland's synthetic natural gas plant on River Road in the town of Tonawanda will be back in operation by next Tuesday. The plant was put out of operation yesterday by a weather-related electrical short circuit. Well, amid all the reports about a two-week extension on paying taxes, we've managed to clear up the confusion. Don't believe it if you live in Erie County. The legislature passed an emergency bill yesterday for upstate counties hit by snowstorms. That bill gives property owners until February 15th to pay taxes without a penalty. But in Erie County, the deadline is already February 15th, so it doesn't apply. The counties where the bill applies are the ones which normally have a January 31st deadline.
Your host, the Family Restaurants, have another great special for you. Your choice of delicious pastry, fresh baked in our own bakery, a 2-cup pot of tea, or 1 cup of coffee. Only 69 cents for our pastry and tea or coffee special. You have your choice of delicious pastries, and you have your choice of a 2-cup pot of tea or 1 cup of coffee. Our pastry special served 24 hours a day, and it's only 69 cents. Only 69 cents. How's that for value?
It's time to play Pick Your Bank. Which bank pays you the most on regular savings? Ready? Start with $100 in Bank A, $100 in Bank B. What she doesn't know is Bank A is really Buffalo Savings Bank. Then add $400 to each a few weeks later in the month. Which bank pays you most?
They're both the same.
Here's a hint. Bank B pays interest only on the $100. The added $400 gets you nothing for the month. Now which bank pays you most?
Buffalo Savings Bank.
Kevin, there have been a lot of rumors about a weekend storm, and please mention the groundhog, will you?
I shall do, John. I don't know where a lot of people get rumors. Maybe a lot of people are just snow-shocked around western New York. So let's try to clear up a couple of things that have been on radio stations and all over that I just don't see at the present time. High pressure gave us a cloudy day today, but bearable. It's moving off the coast tonight, so it'll be losing its effect on our area a little later on. We do have a low system at the western end of the lakes. Yes, it will give us some snow, large amounts, maybe 1 to 3 tonight, but we're talking about a storm like last week, and that's what everybody's so geared up. They're almost shell-shocked, thinking we're going to get another real blast. This system should be in the northern end of the lakes as far as into the New England states, probably late tomorrow night. As a cold front sweeps through, we can be looking for our temperatures to drop probably around the 20 mark as far as daytime highs are concerned. The one I am looking at is in the lower Rockies. That'll be moving down to the Gulf states tomorrow, spreading some moisture northward. And as it starts getting on the coast, that may come up, but we're talking a few days from now. So all of the rumors, let's put them to bed for a while. It looks like we will have some snow, but we're not looking at another major storm for a little while. Here's our trend map, as we have indicated over the last couple of days, showing us what we can expect over the next 24 hours. The low center, which is in the western end of the lakes now, will move up over the New England states. That huge cold front sweeping down, bringing a lot of freezing air, the arrows indicating our air direction as it comes down. The one that is down in New Mexico now will move over here into the Gulf states, spreading some moisture up through the Carolinas and probably the Virginias, snow for the rest of the region, and that's where we are. As far as most of the country, fair weather is going to be their just fate, so a little change in temperatures, some moderate snow, nothing to get excited about. Here comes everybody else. Let's see how they made out today on our Weather with a Beat tonight. And for February the 2nd, let's look at the record books, 1973 and 1961, our warmest and coldest for February the 2nd. Our best today, we managed at 10 o'clock this morning, 24, at midnight, 20. The temperature has been around that area all day long. Our barometer falling, humidity 84%. Winds picking up a little bit later this afternoon, but now have diminished a little bit, southwest at 9. There's your snow information for you, about an inch of new snow to report. Around our area tonight, a low in Bradford of 12 degrees. It's currently 21 here in Buffalo. Arcade, Medina, Lockport, Jamestown, all at 28 for southern Ontario and western New York. The forecast is calling for cloudy with some snow tonight. Overnight low about 20, 1 to 3 inches possibly generally. First team 5-day looks this way. Tomorrow another snowy day with a high of about 30. Wintry on Friday. The winds will start picking up a little bit, gusting to around 30 miles an hour. We'll look for our high dead day of about 20. Flurries throughout the balance of the period. Daytime high Saturday 20, 18 for Sunday, and 20 again for Monday. Well, that's what the week looks like around western New York, but today is Groundhog Day, and finally tonight on the lighter side, we thought we'd check with our groundhog. You've all heard of Punxsutawney Phil. Well, I'd like you to meet Cheektowaga Charlie. Charlie, nice to have you.
How are you, Kevin?
Well, I'm fine. A lot of people want to know, did you see your shadow or not?
Kevin, I didn't have a chance. They took about two National Guardsmen and a snowplow just to get me out of this hole. You can see the kind of situation I'm in out here.
Well, Charlie, I guess we'll just have to keep watching first team weather and find out if we're going to get any
warmer. You better believe it, buddy, because I'm going back in this hole and I'm going to stay warm until springtime comes.
Okay, Charlie, thank you so much. Well, that's what it looks like around Western New York. Excuse me?
You know what? I've been awfully hungry this winter.
Well, I'll bring you a bag of peanuts a little later on. That's it as far as...
You look pretty good to me. I think you'll probably do. Could be the beginning of a whole career for me. Now with sports, Chuck Healy.
There's a television first. I'd never been introduced by a groundhog before. Well, maybe the Buffalo Sabres should reduce their playing roster to 16 men. They played a magnificent game against Montreal with that number, but with a full complement, they got bombed by the New York Islanders last night. They started well. Rick Martin, set up by Gilles Perreault, almost loses it there, but gets it by for the first score. Danny Gare also getting an assist there. But the Islanders came right back. Jerry Hart tied it up, a slap shot that went right on through. Jerry Desjardins takes a late look at that one. Martin did it again for the Sabres. Korab on the slap shot, and Martin right there at the circle tipped it in, and he had two goals, 31 for the night or for the season. The Islanders then scored four in a row. Lorne Henning with the shot here. It was blocked momentarily. Right there, Lee Foglin almost gets a stick on it, but it slides in. Well, Pat Price got the go-ahead score for Long Island. Brian Trottier got two. Lorne Henning with his second, and it wound up 6-3. The Sabres head out for New York, for Denver, and a Thursday night game there. Islander defenseman Bob Lorimer, who made his NHL debut against the Sabres, underwent surgery early this morning for the removal of his spleen. He sustained an injury to the blood vessels attached to the spleen in last night's game. He is all right, but he'll miss the rest of the season. The Buffalo Braves took off just a short while ago for Atlanta to meet the Hawks tomorrow night in a Channel 4 television game. As you know, tonight's home game with Houston was called off early, and the Braves felt they'd better get on their way while they could. They took guard Claude Terry along with them. He was traded to the Hawks today for some cash and an undisclosed draft choice. And Dallas Cowboy assistant coach Danny Rees has turned down that offer to coach the Atlanta Falcons. It looks as though Los Angeles assistant Lehman Bennett will get the job now. And that's sports.
Nationwide insurance agents. They're more than just salespeople. They're professionals, living and working right in your community. Highly trained specialists who can help you build one plan to give you all the insurance protection you need. Insurance for your life, your car, your home, your health, your business. Whenever problems pop up, your Nationwide agent will be right there to help you solve them. Backed by fast, experienced claim service throughout the country. One company with professionals nearby to handle all your insurance needs. That's what we mean by Nationwide's blanket protection for your family or business.
Call Nationwide, 'cause Nationwide is on your side.
Buffalo, you are the reason we do what we do.
You are the music we play. We play it for you on WBEN.
For the first time in days, commercial flights are moving at the Buffalo Airport. And where else would one of the first planes be heading but beautiful downtown Fort Lauderdale? Sheila Allen has details.
United Airlines Flight 955 to Fort Lauderdale may have been 4 days and almost 2 hours late, but they were hardly one passenger short. It was the first flight to leave Buffalo for the warmer climate since the most recent stage of the Great Blizzard of 77 hit last Friday night. Passengers were not the least bit concerned about the delay, however. They were just happy to be heading away from the snow and recent predictions of a freeze heading in this weekend.
Wonderful. We've been trapped since Friday with our entire family of seven people in one home, unable to leave, and although we enjoyed our family, but it got a little airy towards the end.
But we've been leaving since Saturday. We were going to drive, and then luckily we
we're able to take United out today.
Oh, we're thrilled to pieces. We're going to Florida on a vacation, only we heard that there's a cold front coming in down there. So we're taking a hot water bottle.
It feels marvelous. I felt like I was up in Siberia.
We pack our beds each morning for the last 5 days.
For record and information, the weather forecast in Florida is 56 degrees and sunny. Sheila Allen, First Team News.
Any reporter who didn't stay on that plane isn't worth her salt, Sheila. That's the evening edition produced by John Krieger, directed by Mike Cunningham. Now stay tuned for the CBS Evening News and join with Chuck and Kevin at 11 tonight for all that happens between now and then. Good evening.
This is the CBS Evening.